Hello my dear students, a very pleasant morning to all of you. So today we are going to start a new chapter. Chapter number 7, the male merge. So first of all, what is a male merge? So you all are familiar with the Microsoft Word. So male merge is an important feature of Microsoft Word. For example, if you are arranging a party, your birthday party, you want to invite number of peoples to your party, then you have to send personal messages to your friends. But mail merge provide you the facility that you can send a single letter, a standard letter or a message to the group of peoples, to the number of peoples together at the same time you want. So let us start. In MS Word, the mail merge option is an important feature. Many a time we need to send a standard letter to many people at the same time. For example, a letter announcing a grand meeting in your school may need to be sent to a number of people, including the parents, sponsors, and many others. For this, we type the body of the letter in MS Word, and the mail merge makes multiple copies of the letter with the name and addresses of the persons available in the records. Okay, so this is the work of mail merge. You can type a body of the letter like the document in the MS Word, and then a mail merge will make multiple copies of that letter, and it will type the name and addresses of the persons which will be available in your records to whom you want to send the messages. Okay, so this we have seen, the introduction of the mail merge. Now let us move to the another topic, that is mail merge document. The body of the standard letter to be sent to all the recipients is called the main document, as shown in the figure 7.1. It also contains the required field names for carrying out the merge process. Data source stores information to be brought into the main document. It is called the data file. So what is the work of the data source? It can store the information which is brought to the main document. It means whatever you are writing, the body of the letter will be stored in the data source, and it is also known as the data file. The data file has a table containing the columns for each field of the information. For example, it may store names of people, their addresses, and similar information. It has some variable data such as a first name, the last name of the recipient, and the postal PIN code of the place he or she belongs to. The header row is the first row of the table. It records collection of variables, data regarding a person or the thing. Okay, so this is how a mail merge works. Now let us see. First, this is the main document. Can you see that here the letter is being written? And here you will see that the list, the recipient list is there, in which the name, the title, the first name, the last name, the company's name, and the addresses are stored. So this is how you can create this message and you can send it to the list of the people here. Okay, so this is a mail merge. The process of the mail merge involves three main steps. First, creating the main document containing the body of the letter. Creating the data source that contains the records of the recipients. And last, merging the data source and the main document. So, mail merge reads the data source and physically merges it with the main document to generate the letters for all the records found in the data source. Okay, so first, what is the work of the mail merge? The mail merge will read the data source and then it will physically merge it with the main document, with the letter you want to send. To generate the letters for all the records, for all the list of the people you want to share the letter. So MS Word will create a new document by inserting the new data from the data source into the structure of the template document. The resultant document of the mail merge operation contains copies of the main document along with the information that is stored in the data file. It means the details of the person. Let us study the steps of the mail merge in detail. Okay, so now we will see that how to create the main document, and we will see the steps of creating the mail merge in more deep. So using a mail merge, you can create letters, emails, messages, envelopes, labels and directories. The data document holds the text that repeats for all the merged documents. On the mailing step, you can click on Start Mail Merge and select the document type. Okay, so first you have to write a letter or a message into the Microsoft Word, and then you will click on the mailing step that will be available in the menu bar, and from that you have to click on Start Mail Merge and then select the document type you want. MS Word offers the following types of documents. First is letters. This option is used for composing and designing the mass mailings for which only the recipient information varies. This document type is also used for sending out a format letter or an invoice. Next is email messages. This option is used to send a personalized email to each recipient, multiple addresses in the form of 2CC, that is carbon copy, and BCC, that is blind carbon copy, can be avoided also. Next is envelopes. This option is used for producing the envelopes. You all must be familiar with the letters. In the earlier times when telephones, mobile phones were not there, the person used to write a letter and send it by courier in the form of envelope. So this is an envelope. So you can also send a message written inside the envelope online using the mail merge. Next is labels. This option is used to print sheets of the label. Many addresses can be printed on the same page in the different label formats. Next is directory. This option is used to print a catalog, a design, or any other document that requires printing multiple records per page. Okay, so these are the type of documents which is supported by the mail merge. Now let us see the another topic, that is choosing your data source. Once you have selected the type of mail merge, you can make your recipient list or the data source. Besides creating it in MS Word, you can import it from MS Excel or MSS database also. Please note it down that it is not important to create a letter, a message only in the MS Word. You can also import it. For example, if you want to share a list of the items you purchase with your friends, with your parents, then you can create a table in Microsoft Excel also and Microsoft Access database also, and you can import it in MS Word and you can share it using the mail merge. The various steps to select your recipients are listed below. First, click on the Select Recipients button from the Start Mail Merge group of the Mailings tab. A drop-down menu containing various options will be appeared. The various options are given below. First is Type a New List. When this option is selected, a new address list dialog box appears. Enter the name and the addresses of all the recipients in the dialog box and then click on the OK button. The Save Address List dialog box will appear. Enter the name of the file and click on the Save button. Mail Merge Recipients dialog box is used when you do not want to use the entire database. It is used to select the required recipients you want and ignore the extra recipients to whom you do not want to send the messages. Okay, so here we will see the figure 7.5 and figure 7.6 will show you that how you can type a new list, how you can use the existing list or select from an Outlook context. Now, the next option is use the existing list. It means already the list is existed in your document and you want to use the same list. When this option is selected, the Select Data Source dialog box appears. Navigate My Data Source folder in the Documents library to select a data source file and then click on the Open button. So you have to browse your list and then you have to click on the Open button to open the existing list. If you have an MS Excel worksheet or the MS Access database or any other type of data file, click on the Use Existing List and then locate your worksheet or the database file in the Select Data Source dialog box and then click on the Open button. Okay, so these are the steps. My Data Source folder, that is figure 7.5, will show you that how you can browse your file, and 7.8 will show you that how to select the recipients using the existing list. Then Figure 7.9 is showing you that how you can locate your data file, and finally figure 7.9 will show you that how to select and open your data file. Now the next is select from the Outlook contacts. If you want to use your contact list in the Outlook, like you are saving a number in your telephone, in the same way here also Outlook provides you the list of contacts, the recent contacts to whom you are in contact with, and follow the instructions given in the Microsoft Outlook dialog box. Figure 7.11 shows you that how to select from an Outlook contact. Now, editing the recipient list. In MS Word, you have the option to select, to modify and control your data. On clicking the Edit Recipient List from the Mailing tab, a Mail Merge Recipient window will appear. From this window, you can select or deselect the individual recipient. You can short out or filter items into your list. Okay, so after your list is created, now you want to edit it. You want to add anything new, you want to delete anything from it, then it is also possible. So figure 7.12 shows you how to edit the recipient list. So here we are finishing our session. Here we will continue with how to write and insert the merge document in our next session or the next period. For now, bye bye. Have a great day ahead.